What's up guys, Henders here with another video. Today we're going to go and talk about an amazing feature we received in last week's test server, AMD FSR. I was able to do some testing for you guys to show you the relative performance increase you can expect by using AMD FSR at 4K resolutions. We should be getting this feature implemented within 2 weeks, so not long to go. Really good stuff. First, I really should explain what exactly is AMD FSR. So AMD FSR, or AMD Fidelity Effects Super Resolution 1.0, that's a mouthful. It's an image upscaling technology developed by AMD for PC and console hardware. Long story short, it lets you play games at higher resolutions like 4K without losing performance. So normally, your native 4K image of a game takes a lot of graphics power. So normally, if you're running a mid-tier GPU, you will struggle to run modern games at 4K. You need to lower your resolution to get more FPS and a smoother gameplay feel. But with FSR, you can continue playing at 4K resolution and maintain a smooth experience because the game is no longer running and rendering that image at 4K. Instead, it is upscaling to 4K from a lower resolution like 2K or 1080p. Now, you may know of NVIDIA's DLSS technology, which does something similar but a little bit more involved. So the upside of AMD's approach is that it works on both AMD and NVIDIA cards, whereas NVIDIA's approach is only for NVIDIA cards. Now, here's a list of all the supported GPUs as of the making of this video, but expect anything newer to work as well. Now, consoles nowadays also run on AMD architecture, so they too can use FSR, but it is something that can only be implemented by the developers of your favorite games. So this is why for months, a small portion of the BDO community has been asking Perlabiz to implement FSR into the game. Now, the great thing about FSR is that it effectively allows you to game at 4K with some fidelity loss, of course, but without needing to upgrade your GPU, knowing upgrading a graphics card in the current climate is near impossible as a task, both financially and mentally. Just trying to get a GPU near MSRP is harder than probably getting a Penn Blackstar right now, I'm serious. But luckily, just in time, Perlabiz decided, you know what, we're going to implement FSR. Good time. So now that we've gone over the basics of what FSR is, let me tell you my system specs real quick to give you an idea of what I'm working with. I'm using an AMD Ryzen 3600 CPU, that's the non-X version, so stock settings, 32 gigabytes of DDR4 memory running at 3200 megahertz, a RTX 2060 graphics card from EVGA running stock settings as well, and an older LG 4K monitor I've had for a few years now. Nothing crazy, I'd say. I will say this though, please make sure you're watching this video in the 4K resolution on the YouTube player so you can more clearly see any visual differences in the recordings I've made. Unfortunately, there will be some loss of quality because of encoding, but I recorded in 4K, I uploaded in 4K, so I did my best to retain some quality for you guys to be able to see any differences. Now, as for the tests, I decided to run at 4K resolution, of course, with remastered mode and all the basic settings for remastered mode activated. Now, this includes settings you would normally disable for better performance, but the goal here is to see a worst case scenario, not really an optimal setup. So you may find that your performance gains are even better than what I show here in this video. Now, I should note I am running in full screen mode to be able to go past the 60 FPS limit of my display since it is a 60 Hertz panel. So keep that in mind. As for my initial test, I went to Elvia Fogans. Love this spot personally. So it's a decent zone to test real life performance while grinding. Lots of mobs, effects on 100%, should stress the GPU a bit. I did a one pack clear per setting. So I did a run with native 4K and no AMD FSR, one with ultra quality FSR, one with balanced FSR, and one with performance FSR. The only one that I didn't do was quality FSR for this run, but I did it later on. Now, the original run was pretty rough, I'm not gonna lie. I averaged 28.9 FPS with a 1% low of 21.4. Not smooth at all. It was really difficult to actually get any combos through. Luckily, as soon as I turned on ultra quality FSR, my average FPS jumped to 43.8 with a 1% low of 25.3. A much better experience, but still not the smoothest experience. Some hiccups here and there. Balanced FSR was a lot better with an average of 57.5 FPS and a 1% low of 31.3. Definitely playable with this. And finally, performance mode gave me an average of 79.1 FPS and 1% low of 42.6 on the performance FSR mode. Much better performance, in all honesty. I didn't even really notice a loss of fidelity. I also made a little chart for you guys to see the differences between each setting. The gray shows you the native resolution FPS with no FSR, and the red is the relative increase, basically all the numbers I've just mentioned, but in a visual format for my friends who are more visual learners like me. As for the data and the graphic fidelity, I was honestly left a bit confused because I expected the difference to be a little bit more noticeable, so I thought maybe it's Elvia, the green tint of that zone, it's making it kind of hard to see any differences. So I decided to go back to Heidel and have a more static test and see if I could notice a difference in quality and see how much performance we got from a lot of NPCs hanging around. Now, I quickly realized that the performance increase was there, about the same as Elvia to be honest, but I still could not tell if there was a big difference in fidelity. It felt like the assets were maybe the limiting factor here. The game is not exactly new, as you guys know, 6 years old or so. Still looks better than almost every other MMO out there, but it's got some age to it now. I decided maybe it's time to go all in. You know, remastered mode is not exactly the highest setting. We all know remastered ultra is there, usually only for cinematic and photographic purposes, but you know, why not? Let's check it out. The native ultra mode without FSR was giving me sub 20 FPS. It was a PowerPoint slide presentation, I kid you not. So I decided instead of recording, I'll take some screenshots, disable depth of field so I could look at the details of faraway objects and see if we could spot a difference. I noticed right away that the shadows and slight details of the assets that were farther away seemed a little less clear and crisp than running it natively. Still, the difference I can say is minimal, but the performance gains are definitely there. My GPU, I think, is a little on the weaker side for something like even ultra mode performance FSR, but it wasn't that bad. Now, if you're wondering if playing at ultra gets rid of the pop-in assets, which has been a complaint I've heard personally about BDO since I started making videos for the game ages ago, well, sadly, we all still get those pop-ins even at ultra mode. This is just an engine limitation and will only go away if they update the game engine to the new one they're using for Crimson Desert, though even in the game's trailer I saw some pop-ins, so maybe they haven't solved that issue just yet. So overall, the performance gains were absolutely incredible. My 2060 was able to run this at 4K pretty well. Now, realistically, I don't think everyone out there is running 4K monitors. That's just not realistic. So I did a quick test to see the differences for 2K. So 2560 by 1440 resolution, which I think is becoming a little bit more popular these days. And I use the same settings as my original test for 4K. I just changed the resolution. The performance gains were absolutely incredible. Over double the FPS in performance mode. And honestly, I could not tell the two images apart or the two scenes apart. It was amazing. As long as you have one of the supported GPUs in the list, there is no reason not to take advantage of this new technology once it goes live on our global servers. If you tweak it and lower your settings in 4K for PvP purposes, you can definitely play in 4K and still maintain high FPS so you don't miss out on any DPS while you're fighting or grinding. That's AMD FSR in a nutshell. Let me know what you guys think about Pearl Abyss implementing this into the game. Will you be using it when it goes live? Let me know in the comments. And that's pretty much it for this one, guys. Let me know what you guys think about today's video and this kind of video in the comments or over on our community Discord. We're now public and accepting new members, so follow that link, react to the comment to get your member role, and say hello. If you want to support the videos I make and small donations, you can follow the Ko-fi link below and buy me a cup of coffee. I love coffee as much as I love bells, so every coffee you buy me will be greatly appreciated and will of course come with some Discord perks. Remember to like and subscribe if you haven't already, and hit that bell icon to get notified when I upload my next video. Remember, Bell is good. As always, guys, thanks again for watching. Thanks for listening. I'll see you all in the next one. Take care.